the torch has been passed to a new generation of Americans born in this century.
Hello, baby.
Godspeed, John Glenn.
Hi, I'm Dick Clark. You know, time is a strange dimension. Like these waves here, always moving, taking us along and leaving us with only the memories. I'd like to supply you with some time and let you bring back some memories. The time I'm talking about are the late 50s and the early 60s. They were days when we were growing older or trying to hang on to being young. They were the original happy days, what the film American Graffiti was all about. They were days when we were having a good time and trying to avoid a world in turmoil.
Welcome to Dick Clark's Good Old Days, from Bobby Socks to Bikinis, the generation of crew cuts and cruising. And how about Bobby Rydell, Jane Mansfield, Casey Stengel, and Sandra Dee? They're all here, along with 144 personalities and celebrities we all grew up with. Come on back and remember. Your hosts, Frankie Avalon and Annette Funicello, starring Ed Burns, Freddie Cannon, Joey D and the Starlighters, Bo Diddley, Dion, Fabian, Leslie Gore, the Kingston Trio, Robert Plant, Ann Mira, Martha Reeves and the Vandellas, Short Song, the Shirelles, and Jerry Stiller, and special appearances by Dr. Joyce Brothers, the Captain and Tennille, Miss Lillian Carter, Angela Cartwright of the Danny Thomas Show, Noreen Corcoran of Bachelor Father, Johnny Crawford of the Rifleman, Eleanor Donahue of Father Knows Best, Connie Francis, Evel Knievel, Snooky Lanson of Your Hit Parade, Mickey Mantle, Larry Matthews of the Dick Van Dyke Show, Cubby O'Brien of the Mickey Mouse Club, Ken Osmond of Leave It to Beaver, O.J. Simpson, Connie Stevens, Brian Wilson and the Beach Boys, and Jerry Mathers as the Beaver. The following memories are brought to you in living color and love in black and white. So call your friends and share the fun of Dick Clark's Good Old Days.
We went out of our way to make a dry dog food that's altogether different. New Come and Get It variety dinner for dogs. Come and Get It has four different flavors. Beef, cheese, liver, chicken, in four unique shapes. We put them all together in one bag. New Come and get it. Come and get it. The taste that calls dogs to dinner.
Obviously, all deodorant soaps aren't created equal, or my Safeguard wouldn't be so small.
Okay, but I need that Safeguard deodorant soap protection.
I love the lather.
I love the fresh scent.
What about these?
Most deodorant soaps don't lather up this rich, even when they're big. Here, it's a little small.
Better a small Safeguard than no Safeguard.
For the combination of lather and protection, fresh-smelling Safeguard's the smallest soap in the house.
Mrs. Munson, you have arthritis?
Yes, I do.
Then watch this pain reliever comparison.
What for? They're all the same.
Are they? Two regular tablets, 650 milligrams. These other pain relievers also 650 milligrams, 650 milligrams. But this one is different, 800 milligrams.
Anacin has more pain relief.
And a special combination of ingredients. Anacin gives hours of relief from minor arthritis pain.
I'll try Anacin.
Get the Anacin difference.
You can hood the greasies, you can hide the greasies, you can tuck or tie, or get caught with the greasies.
Or you can condition clean with Agree, because Agree conditioner is 99% oil-free.
For healthy hair, for shiny hair, for clean, 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 beautiful hair, condition clean with Agree.
And don't get caught with the greasies.
Welcome to the last beach party of the year. You know, the beach hasn't changed that much since the good old days. Just the people have. And come to think of it, they haven't changed that much either. A lot of our old friends are here today.
I love my surfboard. I take it every place. Well, Annette, I gotta tell you, here we are again at the beach.
I know. When we were filming those beach party movies, this was like our second home.
Yeah, you know something, Annette? I can't get the sand out of my blood or my hair.
Nothing like the beach early in the morning. So quiet and peaceful, mysterious.
Come on, let's get the stuff inside.
Oh, right now?
Yeah, we've waited a long time. You know, the only thing I've studied this semester is you.
Well, I hope you don't smoke.
Well, there's always summer school, you know.
Those really were good old days. Remember the crazy fads and fashions?
Yeah. You know, we wouldn't have an energy shortage today, in my opinion. If I could give back all that oil I used to use in my hair.
I know, you had the ducktail in the back and the waterfall in the front.
Yeah, all right. Then there was the ridiculous stuff.
They really rock it in Boston and Pittsburgh, PA. Deep in the heart of Texas and round the Frisco Bay. All over St. Louis and down in New Orleans. She just got to have about a half a million, a famed autograph. Her wallet filled with pictures, she gets them one by one. Become so excited, watch her look at her run. Oh, mommy, mommy, please may I go? It's such a sight to see. Somebody steal the show. Oh, daddy, daddy, I beg of you. Whisper to mommy, it's all right with you. Cause they'll be rocking on bandstand in Philadelphia, PA.
Who loves who? Who loves who? Anyone can say from 3 to 110.
Think it's easy, huh? All right, you try it.
Red ones and green ones, yellow, white, and blue. Young and old, rich or
poor. Not bad. I think you ought to work on it.
They don't write them like they used to.
Well, you can say that again.
You know which one was my favorite?
Which one?
Get Ajax, the foaming cleanser.
And it smells good, too.
Double your pleasure, double your fun with double good, double good, double mint gum.
Mr. Clean gets rid of dirt and grime and grease in just a minute. Mr. Clean will clean your whole house and everything that's in it. Mr. Clean, Mr. Clean, Mr. Clean.
And the little winemaker, me.
Oh, Brill Cream, a little dabble, do ya? Use more, only if you dare, but watch out. The cows will all pursue ya. They'll love to get their fingers in your hair.
Does she? Or doesn't she? With Miss Clairol, hair color so natural, only her hairdresser knows for sure.
Oh, brush your teeth with Colgate. Colgate Dental Cream, it cleans your breath. What a toothpaste. What a cleans your teeth. Colgate toothpaste cleans your breath. What a toothpaste. And it tastes so glad.
The coffee perking in this pot is America's best-loved coffee, Maxwell House.
Everything's better with Blue Bonnet on it.
They'll know you've arrived when you drive up in the 1958 Edsel.
This was the Edsel. They said it's the only car that can look you in the eye and say it's new all over, with 18 models to choose from. Went on the market exactly 20 years ago, and 2 years later, after a loss of $350 million, the Edsel was dead. Now, this was a hot set of wheels. A car like this was a vital necessity for that most vital of all teenage necessities, cruising. And if the parts of a teenager's car were to be ranked, then this little device would have been at the very top of the list because, hey, if it didn't have a radio, it probably wasn't worth driving.
Okay, Danny Laddies and Finger Poppers, here's a dedication from Leo to Francine, from Paco to Little Mary, from Denise to Alvin. It's the Shirelles doing their latest pick to click. Will you still love me tomorrow?
Love you.
Well, here we are, Wilma.
This is your idea of an anniversary present, dragging me to a drive-in movie?
It's not just the movie. It's the drive-in. Don't you remember?
Remember what?
This is where we had our very first date.
What?
Remember, we saw Godzilla.
I don't remember Godzilla.
Oh, come on. You were all over me.
I was what?
You couldn't keep your hands off me.
Oh, you are dreaming.
You were so funny, so sweet, so feminine, so...
Stop it.
Like a girl.
Will you stop it? We are in a public place.
Hey, remember these?
What is that?
3D glasses. I say, boom, boom.
People are staring at us.
You were so frightened I had to protect you. That's when you fell in love with me.
Oh, I fell in love with you? Stop, when?
June 18th, 1958. I remember it so well. I just got my permit. You couldn't wait to get into my hopped-up hot rod.
Wendell. Wendell, hold me close. I'm scared.
Hey, baby, it's only a movie.
No.
That Godzilla's a fake.
I'm scared he's gonna come and get me.
Hey, have no fear. Big Wendell's here.
Oh, Wendell. Give me a hickey right there so the girls in gym class can see they'll die.
Sorry, baby, that's enough for now.
Oh, Wendell.
I got something for you.
Oh, Wendell.
This ring.
Oh!
I want you to have it.
Wow! Oh,
nothing
Wendell.
Too good for my chick. Hey, Wilma.
Oh, Wendell.
I don't want you to do something now that you're going to regret later.
Oh, Wendell.
Calm down. Have some sense, Anna.
Wendell, I was there. Don't you remember what really happened?
No! It's disgusting! Oh! Oh, it's coming at me! Save me! Save me!
Wendell!
Oh.
Put yourself together. It's only a movie. Wendell, those aren't real Japanese people being eaten by Godzilla. Godzilla is just a puppet.
Oh, it's coming in a car!
Wendell, that's just a moth on the windshield. It's all gone.
No, it isn't.
Wendell.
It wiped out a city. Next, it'll be the entire drive-in.
Wendell.
I want to go home.
Wendell.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Wilma. That's the way it was?
Mm-hmm. That's the way it really was, Wendell.
Boy, was I a jerk.
Oh, no, honey, you weren't. You were, well, you know, you're not the same guy. That was almost 20 years ago. You've changed. You've grown.
I have?
You bet you have, Tiger.
Oh! It's awful! Look at those ears! Those teeth!
Wendell, the movie hasn't even started yet. That's just the Bugs Bunny cartoon.
I was just kidding.
20 years ago, this 10-year-old Texas girl, like millions of other little girls, was all dolled up for the Easter parade. Who would have thought she would become one of the most famous women of the 70s? Farrah Fawcett Majors.
This good, your hometown Pizza Hut restaurant, home of pan pizza.
Ah. Hurry, they'll be here soon.
And your legs, they look so silky. Are those silk stockings?
No, they're sheer elegance pantyhose, new from Legs. They look and feel like real silk.
Ooh, they're soft and smooth like silk, and so sheer and luxurious.
You look terrific.
It's sheer elegance.
Leave it to Legs.
Nothing beats a great pair of legs.
New sheer elegance. Looks and feels like real silk.
Around 2:30, I've really gotten hungry. And I need something. And that something is a Snickers bar.
Satisfying.
realize people like Snickers as much as I do.
Incredible.
Terrific.
It's so satisfying.
Snickers is packed with peanuts.
Peanuts and peanut butter nougat, caramel and milk chocolate.
It's chewy. It's not gooey.
Packed with peanuts, Snickers really satisfies.
I feel good about what I'm eating.
Is the Energizer just another battery? Is the Indy 500 just another race? The Energizer from EverReady Technology. Of all leading brands, nothing outlasts, nothing outperforms the Energizer. EverReady made sure. Your photo flash, calculator, toy, they'll tell you.
Energize me.
The Energizer. Energize.
Long life. Long life.
Everybody
comes to Surfing USA. It's Barbara Mandrell and the Mandrell Sisters with comedy, music, and variety.
I'm the variety.
With special guest Kenny Rogers, a new series premiering Saturday.
Bonjour. Action. James.
Bonjour, jeans. Available at Macy's, Bambergers.
Get great values on great outdoor boots for your family. Save $5 on Colorado hikers and selected Western boots. At Kinney, the great American shoe store.
It's new. It's now. It's finally here. It's television's new season. It's in complete detail in TV Guide magazine.
The hunt for the killers of a Newark cop at 11.
Everybody wants to Surfing USA.
You look terrific.
Thank you. I feel great.
You had some great songs back in the good old days. I mean, songs like It's My Party, You Don't Own Me, Judy's Turn to Cry.
Thank you, Frankie. You know, most people don't realize that there really was a Judy, and she really did run off and marry my boyfriend, Eddie.
Really? What happened to them?
Well, let me put it to you this way. Now it's Eddie's turn to cry.
Why is that?
Last time I saw little Judy, she weighed 450 pounds.
450? Sing, Leslie. 450 pounds.
It's my party and I want to.
Thank you.
During the good old days, this was the setting for the popular television show 77 Sunset Strip. One of the stars of that show was the Fonzie of his time, Ed Burns. Everybody knew him as Kooky.
Right in the groove, Dad.
Let's detour down. If you got to make with the Mysterioso, include Mr. LaRocca. He's from respectability, though.
Eli?
Baby, it begins you.
Right, Dad.
The swankiest. It's Ultraviolet.
I know you don't know. You're Ed Burns.
Yeah. How are you?
Jerry Mathers.
Hey, Jerry. Wait a minute. Weren't you in Beaver? Leave It to Beaver.
Leave It to Beaver, yeah. Yeah, I used to be the Beaver. Hey, that was a long time ago. When I think back now, I can hardly believe it.
Yeah.
You used to spend a lot of time here, didn't you?
Yeah, I used to do the old 77 series here.
Yeah.
What are you up to now?
Well, I work in real estate.
Hey, good for you.
What about yourself?
I'm on my way over to the studio. I just did a picture called Grease.
Oh, yeah, that should be a good one.
Yeah, it'll be out next year. Hey, Jerry, nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you.
Okay.
Hey, Dick Clark, he's having a big beach party for all the people on TV in the 50s and 60s.
Is it going to be any fun?
Oh, it'll be a great time.
Okay, it sounds good.
Okay, I'll look forward to seeing you there.
Thanks, Jerry.
Goodbye now.
Hey, who's that on the radio?
Fabian. It's his new hit record. He's going to be here any minute.
Really? That's terrific.
I can't tell you how much Fabian meant to me when I was growing up. I had his pictures all over my wall, and at night I'd play his record Turn Me Loose over and over again until I fell asleep. I don't know what I'm telling you all of this for. It must sound ridiculous.
No, come on. It can't be ridiculous. You know, I know somebody who did the exact same thing you did.
Who's that?
Fabian. How are you, Babe? Good to see you. How's everything? Yeah, nice to see you, Babe. I'm a big fan of yours, yeah. Got all your records, everything. Surf's up.
The late 50s, early 60s were exciting times for me.
My name's Marshall Lee, producer with Max Bear Productions. You may have seen Ode to Billy Joe, but in the good old days, I was nuts. As a singer in a rock group, the Hollywood Argyles, we made only one hit record, went all the way to number one for 13 weeks. Alley-oop.
There's a man in the funny papers, we all know.
On the right, that's Bobby Ray, our sax man. We've all lost contact with him. That's me in the middle. In the tree is Derry Weaver, our guitar player. Last I heard, he was killed in an automobile accident somewhere in Canada. The fellow dancing there is Spider Webb, who is our dancer and drummer. Currently still playing drums somewhere in California. And of course, our lead singer, Gary S. Paxton, the leader of the group, who put us all together and produced the record.
Hollywood was a long time ago, and so much has happened to me. A lot of good and a lot of very bad. I've been rich and broke four times. I've had 15 million gold seller records. But I've had 13 years of drug addiction and alcoholism, too. A lot of bad things. It all ended up in a mental hospital in Bakersfield, California. And after I got out of there, I moved to Nashville. And one night 6 years ago, I got saved. And I kicked everything in one night by the power of God. Since then, I've had 20 hits, and I won a Grammy for my first album this year, and I'm doing a TV special with the PTL Network, and I'm a partner in a million-dollar publishing and studio operation, and I'm higher than I've ever been in my whole life. Every day is fantastic, walking with Jesus, under God's direction, and that's whatever happened to me. God bless you.
Jimmy was in submarine duty when his father died in 1953. He was a nuclear sub, and it was hard to get him out of there. But he finally got out and came straight home and started working the peanut business. Jimmy had to order books to learn about peanut business, everything about it, because although he'd worked in the fields when he was a small boy, he had done nothing like this for about 11 years. He built up the business in 3 years, it had tripled. In 1957, Billy came home, and Jimmy had been a little bit bored, I think, just looking after peanuts and talking to farmers and going to church. He was just a little bored. He decided to go into politics, which he did. And that's it.
I leave you gentlemen now. And you will now write it. You will interpret it. That's your right. But as I leave you, I want you to know, just think how much you're going to be missing. You don't have Nixon to kick around anymore.
You would cry too if it happened to you.
No little cinnamon gum freshens breath longer than Big Red.
So kiss a little longer, sing a little longer, laugh a little longer, longer with Big Red.
Is the perfume no two women can share, Cachet. It picks up each woman's special chemistry and creates a new, totally unique fragrance on every woman who wears it. Other women may wear Cachet, but you make it yours alone. Cachet by Prince Machiavelli. The perfume no two women can share.
Instant photography by Kodak and The Gift. The Kodak Colorburst 250 Instant Camera captures the colors of Christmas with a built-in electronic flash and bright, brilliant color by Kodak.
Everybody get close. This one's going on dark.
Closer than a gift of instant memories from Kodak.
He's got to finish the spinach before he can come out.
The snow will melt by then.
Eating right during the winter is important.
But as a government survey has shown, 9 out of 10 preschoolers didn't get the recommended levels of iron, and 5 out of 10 didn't get enough vitamin C or A. But Flintstones Plus Iron helps make sure kids get the iron and 10 essential vitamins they need. Flintstones, we make them for kids, because the odds are against them.
I'm finished!
So are we.
It's the premiere of Barbara Mandrell and the Mandrell Sisters.
I'm gonna be the sex symbol.
They're the sweethearts of Saturday Night with guest Kenny Rogers. Then, the secret war of Jackie's girls. They were pilots by day and women by night. Marriott Hartley and Ben Murphy star in a TV premiere. Barbara Mandrell, then Jackie's girls, Saturday. Saturday from the network that brought you Saturday Night Live.
Ooh-wee.
Roadshow takes you to see a real-life animal house. Hosted by Second City's John Candy. Roadshow.
Do you know who these people are? They were all child stars on hit television shows in the late 50s and early 60s. How many of them look familiar?
Well, I don't know. How much did you have in mind?
50 cents, Jeff, my crafty.
50 cents? That's a lot of money for a little girl. Is that how much your mommy's been giving you?
Here, gave me that. I'm a poor, underpaid kid.
Hi, I'm Angela Cartwright. I played Linda Williams on the Danny Thomas Show for years. That was a long time ago. Now I'm married, and I'm still acting. My husband and I, we just opened a gift store in Toluca Lake. It's called Rubber Boots. Hey. See if you can guess who this person is.
Oh, Father, I'm so mixed up. I don't know what I'm doing.
Where are you?
I wanted to see my thinking place beside the stream again. I guess I thought it'd solve something. But it didn't.
Oh, that ponytail. I'm Eleanor Donahue. I played Betty Anderson on Father Knows Best. I continued acting all through the years. And, married and had four children. The oldest one is 20, 15, 12, and 9. And I'm currently starring with Larry Pressman on the NBC series Mulligan Stew. Hope you'll all watch it.
Well, my real name was Richard Rosebud Petrie, and that was the Dick Van Dyke Show. And I'm Larry Matthews. And that was a great show. I had a lot of fun. Well, I'm finishing up at UCLA right now, and I've been teaching a couple acting classes there the last year. And, I guess I've always loved acting. I'd like to do some more of it.
Well, it's new and mighty fine country, son. There's no looking back. Don't come too far.
I wasn't really looking back. Just remembering that.
That was me early in my career. I'm Johnny Crawford, and I was one of the original Mouseketeers, along with Cubby and Annette. Then I, became a serious thespian, traded my tap shoes for cowboy boots, and I'm still acting, I'm still single, and I still ride into North Fork once a week and visit Pa at the old folks' home.
I'm Noreen Corcoran, and I was on a series called Bachelor Father. I played Kelly Gregg, and the series starred John Forsythe, Sammy Tong, and myself. My brothers and sisters were all active in the business also, and my brother Kevin is currently working for Disney's still, and my brother Hugh is a writer and actor. I'm working for a publisher in the San Fernando Valley, and I like it, but sometimes I miss acting.
The club that's made for you and me.
I don't believe it. Boy, it's sure great to look at those shows. I'm with the Carpenters now. Of course, I'm Covey O'Brien. I used to be a Mouseketeer, but on the road with Karen and Richard Carpenter, sometimes people come up to me and they say, is that the same Karen? And I say, no, it's a different one, but I'm really happy to be with them. But those old days were really great.
But there's one kid from the good old days who never grew up.
What time is it?
Yes, sir. And boys and girls here in Dutyville, kids all over America and Cincinnati, Ohio, let's go!
Hallelujah!
watching these little kids singing along with Buffalo Bob, it's kind of hard to believe that today, these kids are all in their 30s.
I really do. You must have started out with the Belmonts. I mean, just hanging around, singing together.
Street corner music, homemade music, hit cardboard boxes, old soap. You want to make me cry, that won't be so hard to do. And if you should say goodbye, I'll still go on loving you. Each night I ask the stars above, why must I be a teenager in love?
Snooky Lanson, how long was your hit parade on the air?
I was on the hit parade for 8 years. Mm. I started in 1950.
When was the last time you sang it?
The last time was in June of 1957.
That was 20 years ago.
20 years ago.
What are you doing now?
I'm with Lamar Outdoor Advertising in Nashville. I sell billboards.
Now, when this rock and roll thing came along, how did you all feel about singing songs that were made popular by Fats Domino and the Everly Brothers and Bill Haley and Chuck Berry and so forth?
Well, it was a little hard for us because we kind of associated ourselves with people like Nat King Cole or Frank Sinatra or Les Paul and Murray Ford. And so doing the stuff with Fats and Chubby and the rest of them was a little far to the left for us.
You did a Chuck Berry song.
Yeah.
Up in the morning and out to school. Is teaching the golden rule, American history and practical math. You study them hard, hoping to pass.
This week, number six on your hit parade, Snooky Lanson digs into his pencil box and sings School Days.
Ring, ring goes the bell. The cook in the lunchroom's ready to sell. You're lucky if you can find a seat. You're fortunate if you have time to eat. Back in the classroom, open your books. The teacher don't know how mean he looks.
That wasn't too uncomfortable, was it?
Well, not really, but you know what really threw me was the name of some of the crazy names those people had, Dick, like Fabian, Dion, Elvis, Conway, Fats, Chubby. Crazy names.
Yeah, Snooky, yeah. Yeah, but those old rock and roll songs, I mean, they were hard for the adults to sing or even listen to.
I bet we could sing a medley of some of the big hits from the good old days and tell an entire love story.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Those oldies by Trinity remind me of you. The songs of the past bring back memories of you. Oh, I wonder, wonder who, do-do-who, who wrote the book of love. What's your name? Is it Mary or Sue? What's your name? Do I stand a chance with you?
And my number is
back.
Don't talk back.
Who put the bop in the bop, 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 bop?
Who put the ram in the ramble and the ding dong?
Who put the bop in the bop, shoo bop, shoo bop?
Who put the dip in the dip, dip, dip?
Who was that man? I'd like to shake his hand. He made my baby fall in love with me. He made my baby fall in love with me.
Rock and roll rhythm has been the seed of trouble, and we want to keep trouble out of Jersey City, Don.
Right here in River City, with a capital T, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool.
This is a child of the 50s, Robert Klein.
I was looking for my bookmark. I can't go in yet because I have to wait an hour after 8. When I was a kid, my father used to tell me that. Never go in swimming till 1 hour after you're eating, or you will drown immediately. Do you understand that? That could make a kid crazy. Okay, Pop, you know. I used to think the food would know. 58 minutes. 59 minutes. If I went in 59:30, pop, bottom of the ocean, drown immediately. When I got a little older, he told me, well, you don't really have to wait an hour. He said, it depends on what you had. And he was the arbiter on the beach who told you how long you had to wait by what you had. What'd you have, peanut butter and jelly? 28 minutes. Tuna salad sandwich, mayonnaise, lettuce, 37 minutes. What'd you have, hot dogs and beans? You cannot go in swimming this year. You can never swim again with hot dogs and beans. It's so heavy, you know. You know, I used to be very musical at that time. I was in a rock group called the Teen Tones. And we used to sing doo-wop rock and roll, not usually on a beach. The best place for it was in the boys' room of my high school. For the echo, you know. And we sounded so great in the toilet. The echo, you know. We got cocky. Let's record. Come on, let's record. Come on, we got to record. Unfortunately, we couldn't find a recording company executive who comes to the toilet to hear us. They normally didn't audition their people there, and we only sounded great in the toilet. Anywhere else we sang, we sound like we were singing in the toilet, you know. When we sang in the boys' room, we sounded like we were in a recording studio. And we were on the Ted Mack Amateur Hour back in 1957. Sang a song called, Sunday Kind of Love. Fast. I want a Sunday kind of love. You know, one thing about 50s singing, a lot of that doo-wop singing, you know, they use a list. I love you so, so, oh, darling, say you love me. Say, I love you so. So, say. But anyway. We thought we were so good. Well, Mr. Mack, we'd like to do for you Sunday. I want a Sunday kind of love. The group, forget it. We were defeated by a one-armed pianist. Well, I have a song for you today, and it's a love song, a sweet love song from that period that I love so much, and it meant a lot to my girl and me.
Among My Souvenirs. Again, Connie Francis. Traveled a long road since then. You've been all over the world. You've been eminently successful. Let me ask you about the future.
Well, I'd like to sing for about another 2 or 3 years and keep up the pace that I am now with the travel and the excitement and the glamour. And then I would like to go into another part of show business, either in the management end and take a new talent and make him or her a star. And also in the having my own record company. Oh, boy, would I like to rewrite another script, Richard. Gosh, I never managed another singer, and I never owned my own record company. And I'm still doing the same old thing. I'm recording 2 Sadaka tunes next week and traveling to England and to Germany. My gosh, life really isn't that simple after all, is it?
No, what you find out, it isn't all the ponytails and going to the malt shop and going to the sock hop.
Twisting, the jet set mingled with the 60s kids who created the dance. And the center of it all was a small, smoke-filled nightclub on New York's 45th Street, the Peppermint Lounge. Here's the man who gave the biggest dance fad since the waltz a home, Joey D and the Starlighters.
Well, we got a new dance that'll go like this. The name of the dance is the Peppermint Twist. Like this, the Peppermint Twist.
Round and round. was going to school. I was just graduating from Santa Monica High School, and I wanted to work for Fats Domino, doing anything, maybe even playing behind him as a piano player.
Let's see, during the good old days, I was living in Montgomery, Alabama, where I grew up. I'd just gone into high school, and I wanted to be a great singer. I really did. I wanted to be a great singer, maybe sing with a big band like Lena Horne or something like that. That's what I wanted to do more than anything. And I didn't think a little girl from Alabama would ever do it. I sort of did it.
Up in the morning and out to school. The teacher is teaching the golden rule. American history and practical math. You study them hard, hoping to pass. Working your fingers right down to the bone. The guy behind you won't leave you alone.
Sometimes, if you heard what people think,
checking out the new guy.
Cute, but he's scratching his head. Could be dandruff.
Likes the hair.
No flakes, but that itch probably needs Head and Shoulders.
She's gonna say hi.
Even if no one tells you, your itch could be telling them you've got dandruff. But Head and Shoulders every time handles that itch, treats hair gently, so all people notice is healthy-looking hair.
Great hair. Hi.
Head and Shoulders. Because that little itch should be telling you something.
We looked at BMW and Accord because we wanted a refined road car. Then we looked at and drove this new Mazda 626. That's all it took.
Just one look. That's all it took. Yeah, just one look. That's all it took.
This new Mazda 626 has great road manners, plus impressive mileage. And the more we looked, the more we liked the looks of its price.
The more you look, the more you like.
Today's the day all the parents go to school to meet the teacher. And I'm the teacher. I'm going to need all the confidence I can get. That's why I'm glad I'm using Dial soap.
Dial, the leading deodorant soap, gives you twice the active deodorant ingredient as a number two brand. Twice the active deodorant ingredient.
Miss Burke, this is my mom.
I am so glad to meet you.
Dial, with twice the active deodorant ingredient.
Aren't you glad to use Dial?
JCPenney's incredible MCS Series 35-watt receiver, three-way bass reflex speakers, and belt drive turntable. One sound will tell you all you need to know about their specs. One look will show you what a great buy they are at $729.80. But look again. Right now, these incredible components are on sale for an unbelievable $499. JCPenney's MCS Series 35-watt system sale. The value is crystal clear.
This is NBC News Update, brought to you by Lipton Tea. Now here is Emery King.
Good evening. President-elect Reagan says William Simon and George Shultz have taken themselves out of consideration for cabinet positions in his administration. The incoming chairman of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, Senator Charles Percy, believes he convinced Russian leader Salt II is dead. 10 survivors were found in the rubble of a hospital in Avellino, Italy, 5 days after the earthquake that killed thousands. A strong earthquake here rocked the mountains of the High Sierra today, but no serious damage was reported. Firefighters are holding their own against the giant brush fires raging in Southern California, but many are suffering now from colds and smoke inhalation. I'm Emery King in Washington. More news later on this NBC station.
Meet Lipton iced tea lover Don Meredith.
You drink other cold drinks in the winter? Then enjoy Lipton iced tea, made from Lipton's quality blend. Dandy tasting.
Yabba Dabba Doo, have we got a morning for you. First, it's Godzilla and Hong Kong Phooey. Then it's the Flintstone Comedy Show with my new neighbors, the Frankenstones and Captain Caveman. All in never-before-seen adventures. Followed by the Daffy Duck Show and Batman and the Super 7, Saturday mornings on NBC.
You know something? With the right handling, you can go all the way.
Tommy D. He was a sax player who had gone as far as he could go.
I ain't no rock and roll star.
He had the look. He had the talent. But this man had the dream.
I can make it happen for you, kid.
Here is my love. Ooh, yeah. The Idol Maker. He could do it for you. Rated PG. Now playing at select area theaters.
come. The exciting Hess training vans, traveling thousands of miles, training Hess gasoline station personnel. Big, sleek, beautiful. Just like this toy Hess training van you can get for your children, with fun features like a workable door, movable TV antenna, switch-on headlights and taillights, and even the Hess sign lights up. Get the Hess toy van, available only at Hess gasoline stations. Fully assembled, including ever-ready batteries, for only $3.29.
The Amazing King Kong, with new scenes never before seen, Sunday.
Everybody bumps. Surfing USA.
One of the most enduring groups to come out of the good old days is the supergroup The Beach Boys. They sang the title song in Walt Disney's The Monkey's Uncle. It'll never be remembered as one of their biggies, but I'll always remember it because they sang it to me.
She loves the monkey's uncle. She loves the monkey's uncle, yeah, yeah. She loves the monkey's uncle, whoa, whoa. She loves.
When you look back on the early days, what sort of feelings do you have?
I feel like I get a charge, a rush, kind of like an overwhelmed kind of feeling of how did it all happen? How did this sort of thing come together? How could we have a scene like this? It's just too hard to believe because it all happened just like that, you know.
When did that happen? What years?
Well, actually, we were kind of ahead of our time. We got into it in the early, about 62, maybe the first couple months of 62, we had a mild California hit called Surfing. Then things started blossoming with Surfing USA, and we continued on the surf trend. It became national. Everybody wanted to know, God, what's it like to be at a beach? Boy, if we only lived in California, you know. Everything was the California craze, and we helped start that. And people would move out to smoggy LA. They'd find out it wasn't all they thought it was, you know.
Yeah, let's do California Girls. Tell me about it, because that's one of my all-time favorites, so I've got a couple of others. How did you come to write it?
Well, I was sitting down at a desk somewhere thinking about girls in general. And I was thinking about how, isn't it strange how California girls have always had a certain appeal, the girls that live in L.A. and California. And I went to the piano and started writing, well, East Coast girls are hip. I really dig those styles they wear. I started comparing East Coast to West Coast. And that's how the song was born, sitting and thinking about chicks, you know.
You know, one man's music greatly influenced such artists as Dion and Buddy Holly, Elvis Presley, and the Rolling Stones. The rhythm and beat of his music is unmistakable. He is one of the founding fathers of rock and roll, and his name is Bo Diddley.
Yeah. never changes. But some people do. In 1958, she was Miss Oklahoma, the second runner-up to Miss America.
We are not out to discriminate against anyone. They themselves have stated that they want to come out of the closet and they want to be able to say that they are homosexuals. How can we know they're homosexuals unless they say so? I can't tell the difference.
Come on, fellas, what are you doing in there? Come on, I gotta make a call.
I don't understand these fads.
You don't? Well, then I've got just the person you should talk to. Come on.
Hi.
Hi. Frankie, I'd like you to meet Dr. Joyce Brothers.
Hello, Frankie. Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Annette. Sit down.
Love your office here.
I just had the air conditioning put in.
Dr. Brothers, may I ask you a question?
Surely.
Why did people stuff themselves in phone booths in the good old days?
Well, telephone booth stuffing was a fad, and fads help us laugh at life. Fads are never dangerous, but they must be daring. We look back at the good old days for the security we need in these tense times. It's a little bit like going over our baby pictures to assure us we have roots and an identity. You know, the period of the late 50s, early 60s was like a calm before the storm. We were taking our first tentative steps toward the sexual revolution.
These students are portraying what we consider bad taste in school attire and behavior. This student is wearing an ankle bracelet, dungarees, and dropped earrings. Open shirt, black jacket, dungarees are mentioned in the code as not proper school attire. This student is wearing an extremely tight skirt and tight sweater. Off-the-shoulder dresses or earrings are considered improper for school wear.
In the early 50s, Marlon Brando, James Dean, and Sal Mineo paved the way for the teenage rebel films of the early 60s.
You come to my class?
You know, for a teacher, pretty cool. Why don't we cut out and go to your pad and live it up, huh?
He's healthy and normal and full of fun. You know what I mean, too. Don't tell me you never rode a hot rod or had a late date in the second balcony.
Too young to be careful, too tough to be afraid. It's the beat generation of Blackboard Jungle. A world your own kids will never tell you about.
With all of my heart, that it is a contributing factor to our juvenile delinquency of today. I 100% believe it. Why I believe that is because I know how it feels when you sing it. I know what it does to you. And I know the evil feeling that you feel when you sing it. I know the lost position that you get into in the beat. Well, if you talk to the average teenager of today and you ask them what it is about rock and roll music that they like, and the first thing they'll say is the beat.
Well, it had a good solid beat, and you really can understand the words, but I think I might buy it.
The two people most representative of the forces at odds in the good old days were President Dwight Eisenhower, the strong father figure, and Elvis Presley, the rebellious young son. And they both became legends of our time.
I don't want to be a tiger, cause tigers play too rough. I don't want to be a lion, cause lions ain't the kind you love enough. But as a wound of your teddy bear, put a chain around my neck and leave me anywhere. Oh, let me be. Baby, let me be around you every night. Run your fingers through my hair and cuddle me real tight. Let me be,
oh, let him be
your
was the stability of the past, Presley the symbol of the future, and some of his critics accused Elvis, his music, and his gyrations of corrupting America's youth.
Well, the gyrations that you're talking about, as far as I'm concerned, were just was something that was natural. I mean, that's just my way of expressing the song. I can't help it.
Pull up a chair, America. Sit right down there, America. Swanson's cooking just for you.
Swanson puts dinner together the way you like it. Crispy, juicy chicken with all the fixings. With Swanson, you choose dark meat or white meat dinners. You get just what you want.
I got the drumstick.
From today, Swanson, your choice of chicken dinners.
Swanson's cooking just for you.
Football 2 from Mattel Electronics.
I said, who's in there?
Hey, Mattel, I know who's in there.
You wish, Franco. Look at Football 2's quarterback. Ever seen a better scrambler? A better passer? That's a Bradshaw in there.
Looks like a Bradshaw getting sacked to me.
And intercepted.
I guess that's why they painted it Mean Joe Green.
Football 2 plays so great, you think is in there. From Mattel Electronics.
No fair, Susan. You get all the fun clothes.
What's holding you back?
Little things like tummy, hips.
Well, shape up with no-nonsense control top pantyhose.
I'll really look trimmer?
On the spot, this control panty is ribbed to gently smooth and firm where you need it.
Some different.
I'll buy that. And this dress, too.
Oh. No-nonsense control top, reinforced toe or sandal foot.
For a prettier figure.
At a no-nonsense price.
I did join the Army, but I joined a different Army. Uh-huh. I joined the one with the condos and the private rooms.
Has anybody ever died from basic? I want to wear my sandals. I want to go out to lunch. I want to be normal again.
Goldie Hawn is Private Benjamin, rated R. Now playing, check newspaper for local listing.
They're the sweethearts of Saturday night, Barbara Mandrell and the Mandrell sisters.
We're going to try to have everything for you. Music, comedy.
And I'm going to be the sexy.
There's your comedy right there.
It's comedy, music, and variety with special guest Kenny Rogers, a new series premiering Saturday.
Hi, I'm Walt Frazier. And if there's one thing I believe in, it's goals. Like the goals of kids who want to go to college to make something special out of their lives. And the folks at McDonald's care about these kids. So to help them get a fine education, McDonald's supports the United Negro College Fund. This weekend, when you buy a large order of fries, McDonald's will contribute 10 cents to the United Negro College Fund. So buy large fries at McDonald's and feed a hungry mind.
The big sale is on. It's Corvette's gigantic total inventory liquidation out of business sale, regardless of cost or loss. Make fantastic savings on an inventory of millions of dollars worth of America's top brand items. Every store fully stocked. Every single item must be sold. There are no exceptions. Hurry in. Make incredible buys at once-in-a-lifetime discounts. Don't miss this opportunity to save like never before. Remember, Corvette's already low prices are now slashed from 40 to 70%. Hurry to your nearest Corvette's and save today.
Rain causing problems in Queens. We'll have the story at 11.
This is a gal who's 16 years old, and I think probably has a very bright future because she has a great deal of talent. She's awful pretty. And this is a thing called Tall Paul. Let's greet her once again, Annette.
Everybody knows it.
far. But it's all in the game. All in the wonderful game that we know as love. You have words with him.
If you like to lose your money, then be a fool and bet on Sunday. But if you want to have a good day, then put it on clay.
But these things, your hearts can run above.
Soon he'll be there at your side.
With a sweet bouquet.
One of the greatest ball players I ever saw. I had possibly the greatest catcher in the last 20 years. I mean, he's lasted for endurance. Been a great asset to the team. I would have to say I've had three or four great pitchers. I would have to say in 53, when you win five straight World Championships, you must have had the ball. The players must have had it with you. There must have been quite a bit of teamwork. Because we must have fought as hard as, say, the Redskins did the other.
1956, I led the league in every offensive department. And in 1957, I hit 365. Ted Williams hit 388, but I hit 365 and drove in about 100 runs and hit over 35 home runs and all. I played 18 years with the New York Yankees. I played more games than any Yankee that ever played. I played in 13 World Series. I hit a couple of balls. I hit one ball that almost went out of Yankee Stadium. I hit another ball that they measured. It went 565 feet. And really now, when I sit and think about it, it seems like it was some other guy. You know, it doesn't seem like me at all.
I love Mickey.
Mickey who?
Sometimes at night when I'm asleep, I dream that I'm trying to make a comeback with the Yankees. But when I strike out or get thrown out at first base on a hit to the outfield, I wake up sweating and I say, boy, am I glad that was just a dream.
In my arms, a girl with all the charms of you.
Jerry Mathers said you'd be doing some recording here. I'm Ken Osmond. I used to work with you.
Oh, Ken, nice to meet you.
Yeah.
Didn't you play, what was it, Eddie Haskell,
yeah.
Right. Well, what are you up to now? You're working for the Los Angeles Police Department.
Sure am, and I love it.
Terrific.
Hey, listen, my wife is a big fan of yours. I wonder if I could get your autograph.
Sure, why not?
Would you?
Sure, you got a pen?
Thank you.
What's her name?
Sandra.
Sandra. Okay, well, listen, be sure and give Sandra my best.
She's good,
right?
I love it. Hey, listen, you going to be at the party at the beach later?
Yeah, I thought I might drop by.
I'll see you there.
Okay, terrific. Bye-bye. So long.
Famous people of today were doing back in the good old days.
Really? Especially in the music world. Here's a little tidbit for you. Listen to this one. Did you know that Burt Bacharach's first music work was a picture that he scored called The Blob?
Yeah, Carole King wrote lots of hit songs in the early 60s, like, Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow? And this one, Take Good Care of My Baby.
Did you know that Chuck Barrett of The Gong Show wrote Palisades Park? Freddie Cannon had a big hit with that song.
I knew that. I absolutely knew that.
I knew.
You know, Freddie Cannon, I remember. I'm the guy that remembers the first time he was ever on television.
With the crazy Hawaiian shirt?
Don't remember that.
No.
In 1959, I was about 12 or 13, and I was growing up in San Francisco, and I was trying to decide if I was going to be a professional baseball or football player, or be like Artie Murphy, but in the Marines. It was about then that my sister Shirley and some of her friends taught me how to slow dance, and I began to realize there was a little more to girls than just being tattletales and being bad baseball players. Needless to say, I became an excellent slow dancer.
Great news. Sears sale on the slack that bends the way you bend, stretches the way you stretch. Flex slacks. now at the comfortable low price of $12.99. They'll keep you comfortable no matter what position you're in. They're made to move with you, thanks to their easy stretch. Now save $5 on every pair. They're made to fit the way you're made, and they keep you looking good no matter what the competition. $12.99 for Flex Slacks. On sale right now at Sears.
Babysitting means sitting.
Oh, come on, Grandma.
Lillian Kimmel is pooped. She needs Coast deodorant soap, the eye-opener. No other soap refreshes like Coast with its exhilarating scent. No soap has bubblier lather. Coast brings you back to life.
That's what we call cutting a rug.
Bring yourself back to life with Coast, the eye-opener.
You buy Crest for your whole family?
Always.
Never something a little more exciting like...
Toothpastes don't excite me. Good checkups, that excites me.
And you always use Crest?
Crest works. And more dentist families use Crest with Fluoristan than any other toothpaste.
But don't you ever want to try something a little...
Always buying the same toothpaste may not be so exciting. But you can bore me with those great Crest checkups every time.
Toothpaste may not excite you, but Crest great checkups will.
That's my husband. He's rugged, loving, and decaffeinated.
I decaffeinated him with this. New High Point. You see, I didn't want him to have all that caffeine.
Ah, but she did want me to have flavor.
That's what's so great about High Point.
It has flavor.
Sure. See these flakes? They mean hearty flavor.
Really great flavor. She's terrific.
And he's decaffeinated.
New High Point from Procter & Gamble with the flavor to decaffeinate the ones you love.
I don't believe it. How could you girls sit around reading gossip magazines? You could be out there swimming, surfing, playing volleyball, surfing, roasting weenies.
You know
anything.
Something? Frankie's right. This is a waste of time. Come on. Let's go where the fun is.
Have fun. Swim, surf, volleyball, weenies.
Sure is windy here, Connie.
Sure is.
Hey, fella, will you lend me your comb?
You know I never carry a comb. What would you do with one? You look beautiful.
We sell 2 million records and he still doesn't have a comb.
Cookie, lend me your comb. Cookie.
Well, now, let's take it from the top. Grab some wheels.
Cuckoo,
dear.
But Cookie, Cookie, lend me your comb. Cookie, Cookie.
Now you're on my wavelength, and I'm reading you just fine. Don't cut out of here till we get on cloud nine.
But Cookie, Cookie.
While Cookie was America's teen idol, another man emerged as America's comedy conscience. You know what? He still is. Mort Salt.
I was on the front of Time magazine, 1960.
was on the cover that year. In 1960, Time magazine was 40 years old, and the boss decided he was getting up in the twilight of his life, Henry Luce. So he had a party for everyone who had ever been on the cover at the Waldorf Astoria in New York. And we sat at tables like this, and I was sitting at a table with Milton Caniff, who developed Steve Canyon and Terry and the Pirates, Jack Parr, Dave Brubeck, Barry Goldwater, and General Curtis LeMay. Yeah, that's the kind of people who were there. And the FBI was on the roof of the building, you know, for security. Rifles on, because the bomb had fallen on the hotel. Our society might have gotten off to a clean start again. we ought to talk about this, too. Presidents became less colorful in the last 20 years, I think. I think that's important. They have no sense of humor. I've
talked to both candidates, and when you see them on television, also Senator Kennedy turns his head a lot. That's his television manner. And waves two fingers. That's a gesture which is reminiscent of a youthful endeavor. I think that's a mistake. Vice President Nixon has a tendency to fold his arms and talk sincerely, and he doesn't get mad, which I think is an area of maturity I admire. And there's a sort of a prologue that goes to every question, whether it's about Redshine and the UN or the farm problem. And it's usually like, as a matter of fact, I'm glad you brought that up. My wife and I were discussing that the other night. After putting the children to bed following the Oath of Allegiance.
And in the 50s, Nixon went to the White House. Of course, he was there. And he was at a prayer breakfast with Norman Vincent Peale, Reverend Peale, and he came out and he called him the voice of God on earth. And it was on the front of Life magazine. Life asked Adlai Stevenson to comment on that, and Stevenson said at the time, he said, speaking as a Christian, which he barely was, he was a Unitarian. You know, the kind of people that burn a question mark on your lawn. So he said, Moses read the 10 suggestions, so... We pray to whom it may concern. Stevenson says, speaking as a Christian, I find the Apostle Paul appealing and the Apostle Peale appalling. That's the kind of jokes we were doing in the 50s. Now, in the 50s, we had a president named Eisenhower who had been a general.
I was in on part of this. I was in the Korean War, which we called at the time World War 2.4. Remember this? The Korean War was supposed to be between the UN and the Koreans. I never saw any Koreans. I was in a remote outpost. All I saw were Americans and Chinese. And then sometimes on Sunday, when the fighting was slow, the Koreans would come up with their families, you know, watching refreshments.
I can remember in Beverly Hills when all of the hip guys in the 50s, you remember this, wore charcoal gray suits and thin ties with a stick pin through their body. Do you remember that? Before the leisure suits. And the rumor was that Brooks Brothers, which was the dean of who administered conformist clothing in the 50s, the rumor was that Brooks Brothers had no mirrors, that if, you know, you go in there and to get straight, you'd stand in front of another guy. That's all right, yeah, well. I want to thank you all for individual perception.
I thank you all for individual perception.
Thank you very much, everybody.
During the good old days when I was 20 years old, my one desire in life was to be a professional hockey player. I was the coach, the general manager, and the owner of a hockey team, the Butte Bombers in Butte, Montana.
Okay, here's our next good old days trivia question. Which famous female singer started out as a secretary for a record company, then sang background music for such artists as Marvin Gaye and Mary Wells, and then later formed her own singing group with a bunch of her high school friends? Did you give up?
Yeah.
It's Martha and the Vandellas. Oh. Martha Reeves.
Thank you.
lot of people don't know this, but the Belmonts and I were on the last tour with Buddy Holly, Richie Valens, and the Big Bopper, whose real name, by the way, was J.P. Richardson. You know, to save some time, these fellows decided to charter an airplane. Their plane crashed, killing all aboard on February 3rd, 1959. Buddy Holly was meticulous about his music, and he was a gentle guy, and he was a good friend. The whole thing was a real tragedy, with a lot of support and encouragement from people all over the world. We continued with that tour. All I remember about that tour is I was in a state of shock.
I love you, Peggy Sue, with a love so rare and true. Oh, Peggy, my Peggy Sue. Well, I love you, girl. I want you, Peggy Sue.
This is Ben Jones, and he's been eating the same candy bars as long as he can remember. Ben, could we get you to try Twix candy bar?
Twix? Why should I? I've been eating the same candy bars as long as I can remember.
But do they have a mix?
What?
A mix, Ben. Rich milk chocolate.
Oh, I love chocolate.
Creamy caramel.
Love caramel.
And a delightful cookie crunch.
Crunch?
Yep, that's the mix.
Mmm, Twix is delicious.
Twix cookie bars, the chocolate candy with the cookie crunch.
Delicious.
Plug into Sears for our most electrifying electronic game sale ever. Protect Mother Earth against the space invaders with Telegames Video Arcade, including one Target Games cartridge, now $20 off. Or lock heads with offense-defense handheld games in football and all your favorite sports, now $5 off through December 6th. Plug in and save only at the Sears Family Game Center.
Well, Dad and George are out of the house, and I've made some General Foods International coffee.
Terrific! Now we can talk.
Celebrate the moments of your life.
I feel like some smooth cafe francais.
Ooh, Swiss mocha. Just for me?
I remember chocolate's your favorite flavor.
Mmm, delicious. You always make me feel special.
Celebrate the moments of your life.
With General Foods International coffees.
Sir, why did you buy a Ford Fairmont?
Well, as a mannequin salesman, I travel a great deal. And Fairmont gets even higher estimated MPG than Citation.
I see. How's the room?
Look for yourself. Loads of headroom and lots of legroom.
How about the trunk room?
Has more than K-Car.
And the sticker price?
Hundreds less than a comparably equipped Citation or K-Car. In short, Fairmont won't cost you an arm and a leg.
Ford Fairmont. It makes a world of sense.
Sunday, the most amazing animal of all time, King Kong. A three-hour special with exciting scenes never before seen in theaters. The immortal story of Beauty and the Beast as it's never been told before, starring Jeff Bridges, Charles Grodin, and Jessica Lange. Sunday on NBC.
American fashion. It's glamorous, hot, and on the move. It's a high-powered business where names are worth millions and careers come and go overnight. NBC reports Sunday.
Rock and roll wasn't the only music that was popular during the good old days. Broadway was full of musicals.
One of my favorite shows, The Music Man, was about the good old days at the turn of the century. I'm talking about days when the sound of music was a big marching band. So now, I'd like to give you my rendition of 76 trombones played on one trumpet.
Come on, give me a break. Let's go see my big solo.
Harrison Ford. But in Camelot, Camelot, those are the legal laws.
Those were the legal laws.
Where once it never rained till after sundown. By 8 a.m. the morning fog had blown. Don't let it be forgot that once there was a spot for one brief shining moment.
Sometimes I miss the good old days. I think Daniel Patrick Moynihan summed it up best on the occasion of President Kennedy's death. He said, "We'll laugh again. It's just that we'll never be young again." Dick Clark. So long.
Up next on NBC Magazine with David Brinkley, how to fight back against insurance companies and a profile of Gene Kelly. Tomorrow morning, there's super-duper excitement and comedy on the Godzilla Hong Kong Fooey Hour, followed by the brand-new Flintstone comedy show with lovable Shmoo and Fred's new freaky next-door neighbors, the Frankenstones, tomorrow on NBC.